to feel down. I said, young man, pick yourself off the ground. I said, young man, 'cause you're in a new town. There's no need to be unhappy, young man. There's a place you can go. I said, young man, when you're short on your dough, you can stay there. And I'm sure you will find many ways to have a good time. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. They have everything for young men to enjoy. You can hang out with all the boys. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. You can get yourself clean. You can have a good meal. You can do whatever.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the slow to start stream. We are going to be playing Myst again. So it's going to take me a little bit to actually get to the Myst because I am painting my nails right now. So you're all going to sit with me while I paint my nails.
A pittance of coin.
Thank you, Nobody, for the tier one sub. Also, welcome to the stream. Good to see you, Nobody. Oh, hey! We got them royalty-free beats, Nobody. Tell me if the music is too loud. I've almost finished putting the initial coat on my first hand. That is a metric of progress. How do I rat jam? Do we not have rat jam enabled on the channel? How do I do it? If you have BTTV, you can, BTTV has its own, in settings, you can open up the BTTV menu, and you should be able to put in Rat Jam. I believe you can also do like colon Rat Jam colon, or whatever the, however it is that you type emotes in Twitch. Pretty sure emotes are case sensitive though. Ion phone? I'm afraid you'll have to type it, nobody. You fool. Foolish nobody. You'll have to type it. No BTTV extension for your phone. So you'll have to manually rat jam. Sorry to say. I've started on my other hand. This is a great game to play after I paint my nails because all I have to do is click my mouse. Hey, Cosmo! What color, bestie? Oh, just black. I have my red with me, but I just want to do black right now. So we're just going for black. I hope you enjoy the ambiance, Cosmos, as I finish painting my nails before we play puzzle game. Bark, bark, bark. Black nails are so fun. I am rat jamming to it for real, for real. Cosmo agrees that the music is in fact going crazy, as they say. Okay, coming back for the second coat, gamers. I have to coat my nails a second time, or else the black won't be quite opaque, and it'll be a little see-through. Those mozzarella sticks? I don't know, Cosmo. I don't know what you're talking about. There aren't any mozzarella sticks on this stream, so I'm a little confused about what you're talking about. Oh no. Hey, Cosmos, you getting gaslit? What are you talking about? What is gaslighting? You know how crazy you sound right now? Like, you sound crazy. It's a word me and my friends made up? Yeah, it's a weird one. My hair is falling into my eyes, and I can't do anything about it because my nails are still wet. Me and Mimosa have been watching Ladybug and Cat Noir. Is Mimosa Mesa? I'm gonna assume that you meant Mesa, but also, a little sus that your phone auto-corrected to Mimosa, isn't it? Hmm? Nobody talks about Mimosas a lot, I guess. Exposed. It's Cosmos. You and Cosmos talk about mimosas a lot? Still a little sus, Bessie. SMH. I don't know, Bestie. Sounded awfully sus to me. Oh, if you hear lightning, that's true, that's real. More of a Long Island iced tea guy. Okay. Okay, gamer. We believe you. True and real? True and real and big and huge, if true and real. Okay, things almost got real bad. I dropped the brush, but I caught it. I'll have to double check to make sure I didn't get paint on myself after I finish with my nails. Can't take breaks in the middle, bestie. You have to finish what you start, you know? Okay, it is done. Currently watching an anime with Mesa. I don't remember the name. That's so true, bestie. I have to flip my hair back. Okay, there we go. Oh, got some more chill jams. What the fuck is this song? This cursed rendition. Oh, I got some on my thigh. Why did that just stop? Oh, it's coming back. It's so hard to adjust your hair without your hands. Okay. Gamers, are you... Oh, it's Welcome to Isle Delfino. Okay, no more background music. Oh, hold on. I forgot to join my Discord thingy so that you can see me. Hold on. Gaming? Actually gaming right now, like for real though, gaming. There we go. What? No more music. We have to play puzzle game now. Time to play Myst, okay? I was vibing SMH. SMH is in Shake My Hands. Because we're going to be vomiting. Hey, nobody? We're vomiting, we're coming, we're pissing, and we are shitting. Very true. Where did I actually save? Yeah, we're looking at the ceiling of the library. Do I still... I put a new red page in. Lactating? Not coming, lactating. What is going... How do you reply on mobile? What is going on with you two? You guys feeling alright, gamers? Anyways, we finally put a new red page into Cirrus's book, so we're going to hear what the man has to say. I'm back. I must continue to help, he says. So he says the red pages are in the remaining ages and we need to get them. Okay. Now we have to do our second age. So we did the boat. I'm going to do the gears second to last. I'm going to do the rocket ship last. So I think that means that it is tree time. Okay. Before we do tree time, if you remember the process... Ban you like I divorced you. Oh, okay. Does divorce he? Is this one? Ah, here we go. Here's the book about the tree that we need to read to understand what we need to do. I've called this age Channelwood, and it is a very different world. Though it is exactly how I imagined it, it is still amazing to see it with my own eyes. Water covers this age as far as I can see, except for a small rocky island. Elsewhere, there are only trees, which go directly out of the water. A myriad of thin wooden passageways are built just above the water and disappear into the forest. I assume they were built some time ago, for they appear aged. I'm eager to discover more about this land and its people, but I have arrived here late, and I must rest. I was awakened this morning by strange noises coming from a pathway adjacent to the one which I had slept. I saw a group of monkey-like people heading in my direction. They had not seen me yet. I did not feel threatened by their presence. Their response to me was one that I would have never expected. After staring at me for a short time, they fell to their knees and began what appeared to be some sort of ceremonial worship. I tried to speak with them, but they did not understand my language. Instead, they indicated, through enthusiastic hand motions, that I follow them. As we walked, I began to notice that the waters below us were changing colors. Slowly, subtly, they would change from a deep blue to a muddy orange, and then from muddy orange to beautifully clear. I was so intrigued by the water, I hardly noticed that we had arrived at a ladder. Climbing the ladder led us to a village, which is about 10 meters above the water and can only be reached by rope ladders that stretch from the lower paths of the village to the village level, approximately halfway up the grand trees. It is very interesting watching these people carry out their daily tasks. Even after watching them for hours, I did not understand what they were doing. At sunset, they motioned for me to follow them. I followed the creatures to the doorway of an enormous hut. Strangely, once inside, I found that the hut appeared even larger than it had from the outside. The walls were garnished with bright metals, and in the center of the hut sat the leader of these people. At least he appeared to be their leader, for he sat a meter off the floor in a thick throne. Guards surrounded the strong creature, who was dressed in many exotic, colorful fabrics. Next to the ladder sat a very old human. At least to some extent, he appears human. His hair, which was only on his face and head, was completely gray, almost white, and hung very long around his frail body. His thin head hung limply by an almost grotesque neck that could not hold up its head to look at me. But what a surprise! This creature could speak my language. Shortly thereafter, I was given a bed with some hand motions that looked to be telling me to go to sleep. I look forward to learning more. As I suspected, the ancient creature is human, but he is old beyond his own reckoning and seems almost insane. However, the tree dwellers almost revere him as a god. They are treating me in the same fashion, which makes me feel very uncomfortable. It is almost impossible to understand this old man. His voice is feeble but wild. He has adopted much of the language of the tree dwellers. Men, love him, need him, crave him, true, nobody. He has adopted much of the language of the tree dwellers. He himself told me that he had not spoken our own tongue in ages. He attempted to explain to me the history of this place. The following is my best translation of what he told me. Many years ago, the humans and tree dwellers lived together in this place, which was then a vast island. They interacted very little. The humans dwelt on the ground, and the tree dwellers lived high above the humans. Occasionally, the island was disturbed by mysterious rumblings, which happened randomly. Some sort of tectonic or volcanic action, I suspect. The sometimes slight, sometimes heavy tremors would only last a short time. Then they would stop, allowing everything to return to normal. One day, things changed. The rumbling began and grew quickly to unprecedented levels. Soon, it became apparent that the entire island was sinking slowly into the ocean around them. Many of the humans died that day, but not before sacrificing themselves in order to stop the sinking of the island. The humans who lived through this catastrophe moved into the trees, where they gradually died out. Maybe because they were unequipped for such an environment, but I am not sure. This is the story the old man communicated to me, although many details are very unclear in my mind. Lobra be putting on a whole show for real. I am especially confused as to how the humans saved the island from completely sinking. In fact, I doubt the accuracy of that part of the story. The island must have stopped on its own. Yet the old man believes in the truth of the story as if he had been there. And the tree dwellers worship him, and apparently all humans as if They were heroes or gods. The old man ended our conversation today with an event which I will never forget. He began gripping my hands tightly, murmuring something about rest and sleep. He then said, "We had expected you to come sooner." These actions filled me with a sort of immediate dread. With much effort, he stood to his feet. I tried to help, but he pushed me away with more force than I had imagined his frail body contained. The tree dwellers quietly surrounded him with very solemn faces. They then kneeled before him. He walked to each and placed his hand on their heads. All the while, he murmured words which I did not understand. Finally, he turned to me and smiled. He closed his eyes and walked out the door and off the narrow path high in the trees. The tree dwellers were silent. They began a procession down the nearest rope ladder. As I descended, I saw several of them pick up the body he had fallen onto a lower level of walkway and carry it away. He was laying down at the dead end of a short pier-like structure. With the use of some potion, one of the tree creatures lit the pier on fire, and I watched as the flames engulfed him. At this strange funeral proceeded, the waters around the pier changed to dull green. This morning I awoke, finding it hard to even believe the previous evening's events. The water is a dull green for as far as I can see now. For some reason, the water no longer shifts colors. Wait, Mimosa, be sleeping for real? As I wander throughout the pathways, the creatures watch me, curious to see what I will do next. They are constantly offering me strange objects of affection. I have even found food outside of the doorway to the room in which I had slept. This is a unique race of beings. I hope to learn their language soon so that I might learn more from them. I have lived on this world for 3 months off and on, and the tree dwellers have shown great hospitality. I'm even beginning to learn bits of their language. I decided to return home for an extended stay with my loving wife and my sons, and hopefully return with them. However, I am sure Catherine will once again refuse. I think this age would be a wonderful experience for them all, and I at least look forward to how Cirrus and Akinar will react to its curious inhabitants. Catherine is staying behind as expected. My sons have returned with me, and they enjoy this age very much. They get along very well with the tree dwellers and are picking up their language surprisingly fast. I have no doubt that it will not be too long until they can speak with the tree dwellers much better than myself. I'm leaving to check on the Osmonian age. Cirrus has suggested that I allow him and his brother to stay. The idea unsettles me. I know the boys are growing up rapidly. The hospitality of these creatures is such that I could think of no better place to leave them alone for a short while, so I will consent to their request. I warn the boys not to take advantage of the respect the tree dwellers have for their ideas. They seem to understand my warning, and I have faith they will follow it. Much to my dismay, upon arriving in Everdunes, I learned that Pran and her people continue to be menaced by the Chothic. I fear their survival and plan on returning to her shortly after checking on Cirrus and Akinar here. See Everdunes Journal for more information. After watching Cirrus and Akinar, I see they are handling things very well, and I can think I can put to rest any fears about leaving them in Channel Wood again. And for a little longer time. The tree dwellers seem slightly distressed that I am leaving, but are happy Cirrus and Akinar are staying behind again. I have been gone for over 3 days and have been many different places. I had to tell Cirrus and Akinar about Pran's death today, and they were visibly shaken. Although they only remembered her from their childhood, Catherine has suggested that it would be wise for Cirrus and Akinar to leave Channelwood for a while, and I have to agree. They will be returning with me when I leave again. I have told my sons that they will be returning with me in 2 days. They spent the entire night telling me of an adventure they experienced in my absence, and it was rather remarkable. It seems they constructed a boat with the creatures and traveled some ways out onto the surrounding waters. I enjoy hearing them talk excitedly of their adventures. They remind me of my own as an adventurous child. I know nobody, but it's like, we don't have to do the reading if you don't want to, because I already know what all the books say, but there's this, as we play through the Myst series, these games have a fuckload of lore, and it's important because then we won't know what's going on. And it'll just be a bunch of puzzles. So I can go faster. I finally understand why the tree dwellers have been giving me their many inks and insisting I write with them. Looking back through my past entries, I see now the inks change from the black I thought they were to various different colors. I've shown some of the creatures my journal and they laughed and howled. I did not know they had such a sense of humor. Even now, as I look through this very colorful journal, I cannot help but laugh myself. We will be returning tomorrow, so my sons are with the creatures for the last night here. They have told me they would like it to come to Channel Wood again, and also asked if they can visit some other ages alone. Though I will have to think over their request, I believe they have proven to me that they are trustworthy and responsible. Catherine will also have to help me decide whether they are ready for travel alone. For now, I must give my farewells to the creatures, for I do not know how long it will be until I visit this age again. So here is a map of some bridges and some buildings. A map of a windmill. Map of a little hut. And that is all that is in the Journal of Channelwood. Now, if you remember, since we rotated the tower, we can now activate the spooky painting. And we can head to the tower to figure out the key to enter Channelwood. Scoot in my chair a little bit so I can not have my hair fall into my face quite so often. So you can see that big giant tree that we were looking at earlier is where we're pointed right now. Nope, this way. If we go up the key side, 7, 2, 4. Okay, gamers. Let's go to the tree and let's see what 7, 2, 4 is all about, shall we? I'm sure you've noticed that whenever we go to the Ages, which is the name of these worlds contained inside these books, they're called Ages. Whenever we've gone to one of these Ages, you've probably noticed that we did not find any people there, even though the journals tell us that there should be people there. That is not an accident. You remember that there is a safe in here? 7, 2, 4. And inside there is a box of matches. Okay, how do I actually use the matches? It's been so long. Is it here? Come on. Oh, I have to strike it, don't I? Yep. There we go. What an unnecessary puzzle part. I actually have to strike the match manually. Okay, put it. Do the thing. I got that. I do got the fire in my hands. Let me heat it up, gamers. Oh, my match burned out. Come on. Okay. I think I did it correctly. There we go. So we gotta crank up the sauce on this bad boy. Have I done something wrong? I don't see the pressure gauge changing at all. Don't. What are you rat-manning me about? What did I do? Oh, never mind. It's working. The tree go up, nobody. Just going rather slowly, huh? Okay. Give it more juice, gamers. Oh, there we go. Pressure's all the way up. There we go. Look at it go. Yes. You see, in order to get into channel wood... No. Oh my god, it's like really hard to get to this area of woods. There we go. There it is. You see that doorway? We need to get into that door. Okay, so I'm gonna turn down the pressure. Because I now need the tree to start coming back down. Gas is off. We gotta zoom. Okay. As the tree is sinking, we're gonna need to nay-nay ourselves into this doorway as it goes down. Okay, here it comes. Oh. I'm in. Oh. Here we go. We're gaming. And then we sink down to the bottom. And inside is the Channelwood book. Now we can travel to the age of Channelwood with the giant trees and the flooded waters. Check it out. So that's the windmill that was in the drawing. You can even see the huts up in the trees. Now we have... Here we are in Channelwood. We got a bunch of walkways. There's almost like a big maze of them. See, there's an elevator here. We can get inside the elevator, but it doesn't work. There are a bunch of bridges along the way here. We can see that there is a spiral staircase over here, and there's another one of these weird wheel thingies. That's interesting. And if we walk all the way back here, at the top of this little hill is where the windmill is. Inside the windmill, there is a water pumping station. You can see that the sound of moving water stops whenever I hold down this lever. Otherwise, that water do be flowing. Now, if I spin this, I can open up the valve of the water pump, and you can hear, as we're walking back down the mountain, you can hear the water moving in this pipe along the ground. This puzzle is all about hearing. So the water is going here. Not this way. It is going right here to this broken pipe. That's no good. Let's try going here. And let's switch the direction of the water. There we go. Now the water flows this way. Ah, never mind. That device is for later. Put that back. Go to this one. Whoops. Did not mean to go past it. But right here. Switch the course of the rotter. Very lost, Papega. Here we go. Wait. Ah, here's the problem. My god, this is very difficult to navigate. There we go. There we go. Okay, good. It's not going that way. It's flowing this way. And now it flows over here to the elevator. And when the water reaches these motors, it will power the device. So now, elevator go up. Oh, I have to close the door. There we go. I always forget that you have to manually close the doors. And voila, we're in the treetop village. There's this little foray right here. Oh, nope, that's turning around. We can go inside, we can go to the left. There's a sort of beat up hut here. Not much to see. Go to the other side. There is a larger building here. How much going on? Empty. Come over here, more empty. Let's see if I can remember what way I am supposed to go, because this place is built like a maze on purpose. Nope, nothing here. Mostly it's just to confuse you. There's no actual puzzle here. It's just navigating your way to where you are supposed to be, which is, right here. This is that other elevator. The one we could not power because of the closed door on that spiral staircase. It was that device I tried to power accidentally. Can I not open this door? Open door. Suppose I can't quite open the door just yet. Oh! No, buddy, if you're still here, I downloaded Project Sekai today, and I played a couple songs. That was fun. By the way, the reason that you get that map at the end of the book is you're supposed to write down the map so that you can use it to navigate the village. Because otherwise it is quite a pain in the ass. You'll see that it does not let me cast my vision to the side and look out over the village as I try to navigate its winding corridors. You also see that there's another layer of village above the one that I'm at right now. Ah. There we go. That's how I opened the door on the spiral staircase. Excellent. Okay. This way. Yes, I remember that stack of things. Here we go. Nobody, I hope you're ready for some riveting gameplay. You have to walk downstairs. We'll come back up here. We'll touch this. Switch the flow of the water to the new elevator. And we'll go cruising right back up. Take me higher. Now I am at the third floor of the village. I'm speedrunning this. I'm sorry. So there's this building. If we go inside this building, we're going to find out what Akanon was up to when he was here with the villagers. So that is Akanon offering for the villagers to give him offerings. You know, put your offerings there. Keep your hands out of his business, of course. At the back, you can see that there's a little door out of this little sideshow that he's built. And if we follow it all the way through, we find a cabin. This was Akanon's little hut while he was here. While he lived here. There's this piece of technology right here, and if we click the button, you can see that message that he recorded to try and scare the tree people into giving him offerings. So, if you ever wonder why these ages are devoid of the people, it is because Cirrus and Akanon, if you remember, Atreus, the protagonist who wrote these journals, whose footsteps were following in, said that one of his sons betrayed him. And we can see that they have not been kind to the people of the ages that they have been living in. If you are wondering which of the two sons betrayed their father, wonder no longer.
I hope I pushed the right button, my dear. What a very interesting device you have here. I'm not erasing anything important, am I? Remember, he is prepared. Take only one page, my dear brother.
Both of Atreus's sons betrayed him. They conspired together to betray their father, and they took one page. That's really important because that one page is the most important clue in the entire game. And without it, we cannot get any of the good endings. We head around the elevator. We can find Cirrus's room. Just like before, it is covered in opulence, because that's what Cirrus is all about. One red page, yoink. And the most... No, where is it? It's here, surely. I did not forget that it is here. Ah, over here. Oh no, that's just a knife for stabbing people. Here we go. This is the other half of the most important clue in the game. Mist and access can be easily if simple. First, locate switches on the island. These switches go to dock and the marker switcher off position. What does it mean? I know what it means. He's got a little toothbrush and got a little sink. A little sink, a little toothbrush, a little cup. Brush your teeth. Nobody, did you brush your teeth today? Let's see. Now that we've gotten the page, I think it's time to head back to the elevator. Because I believe the time has come for us to do a little bit of bridge building, nobody? Nobody and other gamer friends. Back down the staircase. By the way, walking down that spiral staircase is much more convenient in this version of the game than it is in, there's a remastered version of Myst that is actually a full 3D game where you can walk around, which is cool. We are here for this lever. Ah, right, we require water, as is tradition. Wait, hold on, no. Go down here. Switch that so the water will flow to that lever. What way is the water flowing right now? Send it that way. And send it that way. There we go. Back to that lever. We're gonna build a bridge. Bridge time. Wonk. Ba 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 bo 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 ba bo 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 bo. New bridge. Which brings us to this other little secluded part that we couldn't get to before. You see there's another elevator and motor. But to power it, we need to extend this pipe. There we go. Now we can get the water to this final elevator. Actually, I should... Let me make sure it flows the right way. It goes this way. Then it goes... Yeah, that way. And that way. And then that should take it across the new pipe. Back to this one up here. Oh, no, it's already flowing that way. Oh, I think I did it. Yeah, and there it flows. Okay, back to new bridge. There we go. Oh, no. Go inside, elevator, silly. Closed door. Pull lever. Whoa, lurky while I bait? Gross, nobody gonna clean her grippers? Ew. And you can see at the top of this elevator is the Mist Linking Book. Which will take us back to the island. Age 2, done. Now I believe there's just three more we need solve. Put another page inside of Atreus, or Cirrus, rather. Now Cirrus is full of brand new sauce, we're gonna save the game again. Two down. Save. What do you have to tell us now, Cirrus, who betrayed his father? So he, if we get him all the red pages, he will be freed from his prison in the book, and he is trying to convince us that he is innocent of betraying his father. Akanon in the blue book will try to say the same thing, but they are both filthy traitors, and we shouldn't trust them at all. Spin the wheel. Okay. For the last two ages, we have to do them in a certain order. The reasons we have to do them in a certain order is because the gear world will tell us vital information about the rocket ship world. Also, I have not flipped up the last marker switch on the other end of this island. Because I don't remember what time I'm supposed to set this clock. But whatever. God, that noise is very annoying. I'm so sorry. Because I believe that there's one more age, but I don't remember how I'm supposed to get to it. There's somewhere where the time relevant to whatever. We'll find out eventually, right? It's got to be in a clue somewhere. Oh, right. We need to read our books. Let's see. I'm looking for the one with gears on it. Here we go. Hold on, my hair is in my face again. Before arriving in this age, I was determined that it would be a journey to a world very different from my previous adventures. And it was. The sky here is dark and gray, and incessantly displays flashes of lightning in the distance. But a very old man with a long beard. He's very feeble and has trouble even moving. This man has obviously been through very many things in this strange world, and I have learned many things from him. He told me an interesting story about this world's history. Years ago, he told me there was a beautiful city that rose up out of the water. It housed many people inside its walls, and the people had everything they wished for. On the east hill of the city rested a large lookout post. The people of the city had constructed the post, expecting visitors to arrive from the east. The people had no means of traveling on the water, which forced them merely to wait for friend or foe. As time passed, friendly visitors brought rumors of an enemy that existed beyond the horizon. The people grew fearful, yet nothing happened. One day, the usually sunny sky became as dark as night, and black ships appeared on the horizon. The lookout post's attempts at peace were turned away, and the sentries were easily overwhelmed. The ships continued to wreak havoc on the city, destroying everyone and everything. After the foundations of the city were destroyed, the city sunk deep into the ocean, and only the lookout post remained. The black ship sailed away. The man continued to say that 8 people had hidden and managed to survive through the attack. In the 9 years since, 2 of the survivors had died. He also said it was rumored that 10 years from the attack, the enemy would return to finish the destruction they had started long ago. I have decided, since hearing the man's story, it would be admirable to save this civilization and stop this enemy's plan of destruction. I'm excited about the adventure that awaits me, and an idea has sparked in my mind to provide the needed defense for these people. I met the remaining survivors today and have begun to work on a plan for protection. Here's a diagram. After a short absence, I have returned to this age with my 2 sons. They have, as of yet, traveled rarely with me, and when they are, understandably excited to be here. They have grown considerably since the Everdunes, and it is already obvious to me that they will be a great help in this time, instead of the nuisance that they have been in the past. All 3 of us, along with the 4 healthier survivors, began construction today. We are building upon the old city's ruins, which will provide a perfect foundation for our fortress. My sons have been spending much of their spare time on the South Island, where most of my materials are stored. I'm very pleased with their intelligence, and their creativity is refreshing to see as they work on some small projects of their own. It has been over 4 months now, and construction is going well. My sons love the world except for its gray skies. They detest the gray skies and tell me many times they wish to see the sky like it were the blue sky in mist. The old man I first talked to tells me that the enemy is due in 4 months. I feel we will be ready for them when the time comes. The man reminds me of Emmett in many ways, and I often wonder how Emmett and his people are doing. It has been 6 months of work and finally finished the fortress. It rests between the 3 hills, which are now only islands due to a rising water level that the people experienced after the attack inside the fortress. I have designed a most intriguing device. It makes use of a technology called holography. I began experimenting with it on my visits to Aspermere. It will be working in a couple of days after I compensate for some small miscalculations. This holographic device will enable the survivors to learn to use the fortress. The enemy is due to come soon, and I trust the fortress will provide, here's a diagram of the fortress, sufficient protection for all of us. The black ships have come. Their attack was substantial. Their weapons have been stopped, and it appears they have turned away in defeat. I could not help but smiled as the black boats left. Last night we had a small celebration and the old survivors danced their dances of old. My sons did not understand why the sky had not turned back to its original blue. The old man told them that the storms would never end until the enemy was destroyed. I assured my sons that the blue sky was not worth the risk of death, and they seemed to hear me. I've had a healthy adventure and begun working on a new book. Once again, I must leave a familiar age in search of a new universe I have begun. But first, I will have an extended time with Catherine, whom I miss very much. I must also return to the people of the tide. I believe my travels, I have found a substance that will ease the pain of their bone ailments that they have long endured. I hope to return to mechanical age one day and find the population growing and my fortress still strong. Though the sky may always be black, I'm confident the people here feel a heavier darkness that has been lifted from their shoulders. So we are going to the mechanical age. Go here. Open up the elevator, pop in, y'all know how it be, press button. I appreciate how extra this elevator is and that halfway up it actually spins around and then finishes going all the way up. It's the most extra elevator. It's pointlessly complicated. So if we look through here, we'll see those giant gears that we saw on the island. And the key is 240221. Which I believe. Actually, now that we have the number 240, which is the time we need to set that clock to at the end of the island, I could technically speedrun finish the whole game. I could skip every other puzzle, but I feel like you would want me to do all the puzzles. But I believe I could just finish the game. I would have to Google something, but I could. Have no fear. So we go here, we need to set the time to 240. Okay, I believe little one is our hand. Okay, one. Two, so that's 2 o'clock. 30, 5, 40. One, two, three, bonk. That's 240, right? Press his red button. Then behold, a bunch of gears rise out of the water. Flip that switch. And now, when we go to look at the map inside the library, you'll now see that because I have flipped all of those marker switches, the entire island shows up correctly. Which is pretty cool. Okay, remember the second part of our hint is 221. Let us go to this odd clock tower and open its doors. We will find a puzzle that I can only describe as fucked up for real, though. If we take too many moves to solve this puzzle... Oh, I did it. I solved it. I was going to say, if we take too many times to solve this puzzle, this weight here will reach all the way down and we won't be able to pull the levers anymore and you have to reset the puzzle. But I solved it by accident by just flailing on the levers. So that's cool. You'll notice that the gear in the middle rotated up to show an exposed area. And now if we look at the gears here on the island, you'll see it spun in just the same way. And now we can access the linking book to the mechanical age. Wow. This age shall be painful because it's not a hard puzzle, but it is a long puzzle. It's also a very important puzzle because it tells us a key mechanic to solve the very last puzzle in the game. Or, I suppose, very last in the ages puzzles. So now we can see, here we are. There's a thing here. This is the puzzle that will solve the age. We need to find the 4 correct symbols, put in here, and then we'll hit the big red button, and it will open up this gangway right here, and it will let us go home. But before we do that, let us approach this swiveling fortress that Atreus and his sons built for the people of this land. As you can see, there are 2 ways to go. We're going to go left. Ah, and who would have guessed that we would end up in a place belonging to Cirrus? It's a little model of the clock. There's a little boat. A rocket ship. He's got a little telescope out here that can see into the distance, but it just sees gray. There are three glowy prisms. They glow for real. You go brown, 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 brown. They're not a puzzle. They're just there for flavor. There's a little bird, a little wooden bird. And of course, an ostentatious throne for the game of chess here. In case you're feeling like a real piece of work. There's a little wine glass here. You can see all the gold on the throne. Now let's see. There it is. Hold on. I feel like I should reset this so we can actually see what that I just did. There is a secret button on the wall behind the throne. You can actually see the throne. There you go. And if when we push this button, it opened up a little door. If we call through, we see what Cirrus has been keeping secret in here. Lots of gold coins, big chests, fine bottles of wine. Ah, and of course, a red page atop a pile of gold bars. Oh, and what's this? A little scroll. Cirrus, your greed sickens me. Your desire for wealth and plunder is never satisfied. I will instruct my subjects not to pay your new tax, and you know they'll listen to me. Regards, Akinar. So Akinar do be being like that. How do I actually... There we go. You can see that I'm just gripping this red page firmly and with great force. This is Akinar's room. Medieval weapons. A little music box. Play a little shanty for me, gamer. There's a little snake and it goes, yeah, bites you. Very scary. More weapons. And then this. This is the simulator. Fortress Rotation Simulator. Calibrating. This is what will teach us how to move the fortress. In order to move the fortress, we first have to crank this lever like a mad lad, and then crank this lever like a mad lad, and... No? Did you hear that sound effect? Like a spring. A spring is east. This sound effect. That beep means north. This sound, which sounds like you're ripping a fat one, is west. And then this sound, the cowbell, means south. I cannot describe to you how important it is that we fully and totally memorize what all of that was. So I trust in your good faith that you will help me remember that. You see, there's a weird little goofy goof going on in the wall over here. That wall opens up and we can find the secrets that Akinar has been hiding. It is a metal cell hooked up to a bunch of electricity. Just in case you were wondering what kind of person Akinar is. We can see inside here there is a scary skull. Then there's a blue page. A bunch of poisons. So, you know, Akinar and Cirrus, maybe not great people. Maybe, in fact, awful people. Oopsies. You know? If we go to the back of this place, you'll see that there is a hallway here. Not much interesting to do in the hallway. You'll see that I can't even walk around the elevator. If I push this button... The floor will fall away and reveal a secret passage. There's a symbol. There we go. Nope. Whoops, messed that up. There we go. I want to line these two symbols up so that the two circles align their opening together. Fantastic. Beep. Ah, and you can see now the elevator is able for us to enter it. You'll see two buttons. There's a down button that makes the elevator go down. There's an up button that makes the elevator go up. It's an elevator. That's what they do. You may notice that there is a third button in the middle of the elevator. So here we are at the top of the elevator. You notice that there's not really much to do up here either. If we press the middle button, a timer will begin to count down, and then the elevator will fall down and reveal to us a control station to rotate the building. If I press that little button, the elevator will spring back up for us so that we can get up. the time has come to solve the puzzle, which will involve us spinning the tower to each of its four directions and finding we are now facing south. Cowbell means south. Go to elevator, go down. You can use the timer and go down the elevator yourself. If you really desire to. Alrighty. Let's just go out to the front of the fortress. Ah! Oh, I've actually failed to move the fortress at all, like some sort of rube, and now I am embarrassed. Go back to the fortress. We are already pointing south. I feel very silly and very dumb. Oh, hold on. Too far. Zoomed too fast. Flew too high, you know? By the way, this is the reason that this puddle is tedious, because we must solve this timer-based elevator puzzle every single time we want to move the tower, which means we must wait an incredibly long time. And now it shall close, and now it shall sink. And now we can try again. Put it here. Okay, now we're facing east. Call back the elevator. If there was ever a time that you could safely assume that you know what the next, like, half hour of this stream will look like, you're bearing witness to it. It's going to be a lot of me running back and forth to that control panel and just rotating the tower once each time. Now, the reason I had to do the mechanical age first is because the final puzzle of the rocket ship age is a underground rail cart maze. Okay? Underground rail cart maze. Dot with spikes, half circle. Write that down, gamers. It's important. And that maze has no compass directions for you to view, except for the cardinal noises that you learned in the mechanical age. It will be the first, it will be the either the first or the second puzzle that I will cheat to complete, because I refuse to sit here and blindly solve a puzzle for multiple hours while you watch. I feel like that is not good entertainment. Unless you want me to mindlessly attempt to chart an entire underground maze by slowly turning two levers and using a minecart. Set it in the ready position. Spin that sucker. That is north. So we saw a circle being held up by spikes, and we saw a half circle that was on the left side. With this last clue, I will be prepared to just guess the final solution of the puzzle, rather than go to the last island and solve it manually. Because I don't like the mechanical age. It's my least favorite puzzle in Myst. Oh, it just gave us all of it. Down circle and line of spikes on either side. Well, sheesh. Oh, is there only three islands in this version of the game? Oh, weird. Is there not a fourth island? Now I must investigate the fourth island to see if it exists. Because there's four cardinal directions, is there nothing on the... Oh, because there's only three islands. If I turn the fortress to the left, there simply will be water. Right. Hey, good thing we read the books, right? Or else I would not have remembered that there is only three islands. And that we have finished solving the mechanical age. Okay, that's west. The brap noise. There we go. Cowbell means south. God, at least the... you know what? Thank goodness that the elevator is actually fast. In the remaster of Myst, that is a full 3D game. The elevator, let me tell you, is slower than this, which makes the mechanical age really boring. Anyway, any hoozle. Puzzle time. That one. No, that one. I'm looking for circle on spikes, and then I'm looking. Oh, I passed it. That's my bad. There we go. Yes! And at the bottom of this pit is the Myst linking book. I'm gonna put this new page into Cirrus. Let's skim what he has to say before I promptly ignore him for being the traitorous meanie pants that he is. And he will be like, he's like, I am growing stronger.
You must visit the one remaining age. You have not.
He's like, you have to go to the last age and complete it to get the last page of the book. I'm going to spoil Myst for you right now. And I'm not going to help him. I'm actually going to leave him to die. Oh, right, I have to get my puzzle clue. I forgot, gamers, I'm sorry. We hear you, gamers, and we're sorry that we forgot to go look at the puzzle clue before we went to the puzzle. The spaceship is the last age in the game. It is also the most difficult by far. It is very tough to complete the spaceship age. Because it does involve accurately playing the piano in a point-and-click adventure game, so we can see the spaceship is lined up. I should probably read the book about the spaceship as well. 59 volts. We have our number. We must go to the power station and input 59 volts. Bump. Spaceship age time. If you attempt to complete the book and set free Cirrus or Akinaw, they will immediately betray you, trap you inside the very book that you freed them from, and leave you to die. Which is why we are not going to save Cirrus or Akinaw. Instead, we have to find their father, the man who used the art. The art is some form of magical writing. It's how Akinaw, or not Akinaw, it's how Atreus made these places. No, that's the boat age. We already read that one. Which one is this one? Only silence. I greatly enjoy it. This world is not very beautiful. This one is not necessarily interesting. It's just explaining the surface. It's got the cardinal directions. It's got the spaceship. You can see that most of it has been destroyed. I'm leaving today in order to bring Cirrus and Akinaw. I've left them in Channelwood. Ah, here we go. This is the most important hint in the game. Otherwise, we will be suffering. Suffering, I tell you. I'm going to close down chat for a second so I can take a picture of this screen. I hate the piano puzzle because I'm not very good at playing piano. There we go. Photo taken. Puzzle clue recorded. That's why it's so important that we see these books. Here is a map of the island. So we are going to the spaceship age. It's barren like the others, but I think it has the coolest atmosphere. So it's a shame that the puzzles in it are so darn brutal. We're going to go down here, we're going to go all the way to the bottom of the basement, we're going to open the door, we're going to walk inside the thing, and we're going to go... Let's see, where is the... 9, 5... Okay, so let me guess. 1, 10, 7. 1, 2, 22, 10. 48, 53, too much. Ah, shit, I threw the breaker. Damn it. So if you overcharge it, it will break the electrical wires. And then I have to come out here, and then I have to go over here, and then I have to go here, and then I have to climb back up this thing, and I have to throw this lever. Because I overloaded the circuit, and because of that, the good old emergency switch flipped. So I must be more careful. Oh. Oh, I flipped the wrong breaker switch. Let's see, how do I get to the other one? Oh, here we go. Then here, and then here, and then up here, and then there we go. Now I have reset both. Where am I? Where am I? Here. Yes. 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 It's really fun to get into a straight hallway and click really fast, because then you just zoom. Okay, there we go. Okay, 10, 7, 8, 16. 16 is going to be too much, isn't it? It's going to make it 57? Not too much, actually. 57, 58, 59, 59. I did it, I'm doing it, I'm gaming, so smart, puzzle. I solve puzzle. Sorry, I'm just hyped up because I solved that really fast. Normally it takes me a little longer. There we go. And then we'll go. And now, the spaceship will open. Because we have provided it sufficient power. Ah, fuck. God damn it. So, I'm sure you remembered that piano clue. Well, we have to play that pattern on the piano, and then we have to turn around, we have to walk up to these faders. And we have to pick out the five piano notes on fading sliders by sound alone. And input them all correctly, then flip the switch, and it will play the correct sequence of notes. I could solve this puzzle the correct way. Do you want to watch me play a piano and by ear attempt to match a bunch of notes? Because I guess that's what we're going to do. And when I get sick of it, I'll just look up the solution to the puzzle. Okay. Okay. So one is... Okay. That sounds right. Okay, number two is this. Is that correct? That is not correct. No, that doesn't sound right. That sounds pretty close. Okay. Okay, that's correct. That's number three. Number four is... Okay, that sounds correct. And the number five is... Okay. Okay. Answer my riddle, Riddle Master. Fuck. Shit. Okay. Then number two is... That's correct. Is this now correct? Oh, that's so close. Ba 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 ba. Okay. Okay, that sounds right. Fuck. God damn it. Okay. Okay. It's the fifth note, I think. Okay. God damn it. This puzzle sucks. I hate this puzzle so bad. And it's every time I click on one of the sliders to hear what it sounds like, I keep accidentally moving the notes as well. Okay. Too high. I'm too high on the first one. And then when I come here, it's... There we go. Oh! Yes! Yes! Give me the book! The book! So this book is a digital book, and this is what the rocket ship age looks like. Got some goofy crystals in it, got a rocket ship, got a little tower, got some radio dishes. Like, what the heck be going on with it, though? So we have arrived upon our rocket ship. Here we are. Here's an important puzzle. Oh my god, you're not gonna believe it. More puzzles. They make different sound effects. Ain't that nifty? Wow. Oh, there's a staircase up here. Actually, there's a secret path back here. If we follow, it will take us to a grove of trees. They got some nice running water in there. Very poggers. We'll press that and that little symbol will light up. That's very important. Here's a blue page for those of us who care about Akinaw, which we, alas, still do not. There's the gassy chasm button. Got that clicked. Where am I? I'm back on the main path. There's a clock here. Womp. Boom. Makes clock noises, as clocks do. Up along this ridge, there is a bunch of crystals. They hum. Oh! Wait. Page. Here we go. Not this way. Back that way. This way. Okay, here we are at this place. We turn around, we follow the path. We go up, we go down here, and there is the gusty wind. There's a ladder down here. There's a tunnel down here. It turns off and on the lights. And at the top of this tunnel is the radio dish thingy. So first we need to align the first one to the drippy drip. Or the drippy drips. That's not it. Where's the drippy drips of the water? I'm trying to see if I can line up any of these. Unless there... Did I not do something on the radio dish to make it work? I guess let's try lining up some different ones. There we go. Okay, clock time. Crystal time, which is over here. Nope, wrong way. This way to crystal. Now we need the whooshies, which is over this way. Now we need the chasm, which is there. All that's left is the water. I think there's like a blinking indicator on the arrow buttons whenever I'm close. Oh, I need to get them perfect without any noise. There we go. There we go, and now hit the big crap. It tells us the correct order. Crystal, water, wind, chasm, clock. Crystal, water, wind, chasm, clock. Quickly get back to where we're supposed to solve this. First is crystal. Crystal, water, wind, chasm. Last one is clock. Solve that puzzle. Solve, solve, solve. Always be solving puzzles, my gamers. Come on. Yes! So now we descend down this deep and creepy hallway, and we reach this funky little submarine-looking doohickey mabobber. We press the button and it shall seal us within. Here we go. We shall be lowered down into the depth. This is the maze. It is an underground maze. And let me tell you, it is a nightmare to solve. As you can see, our visual cues are, well, not the best. We'll see this underground railway track. We're facing north. You can see I can change my position to make myself face any cardinal or sub-cardinal direction. And for example, if I go to northeast, it is a combination of the north and the east sound, which is pretty cool. You see that there's a bunch of dead ends around us. That's what these red lights mean. These are dead ends. Which means that there is only one way forward. Now, this is indeed a maze, which is why I'm going to look up a guide on how to solve it so that we aren't stuck here forever. Mist, rocket, age, maze, guide. Googling it. Yes, I know it's cheating to look up the solution to a puzzle game, but it really, really is a truly blind maze. Okay, I have the guide. North. As you can see, the animation of getting between station to station takes a long time, and every mistake, we will have to run the animation in reverse. North. Second is west. It's time to go north again. North. You can see it's an awful long track that time. Now we are going to go east twice. quite a long bit of track to get to this next station, and now we're going to go east again. I don't believe that there is a guide on how to solve this maze in game. You simply have to get down here, get trapped, and just keep trying new passageways until you solve it. Now we are going to go south twice. I hope we saw some other track near us. That's a good sign. Unique animations that have different looks is always promising. We're going to go south again. Oh, big turn. Doing some roller coaster. Very fun. We are facing south again. We want to face west. West is to be our next motion. We're going to go west. Ooh, a little bit of an angle here, gamers. Those big loops. All right, here's our next station. We are going to go southwest now. That's southeast, my mistake. Southwest. More fun loop-de-loops. Now we are going to go to the west. Oh, I've gone the completely wrong direction to get west. My bad. Ah, west. Here we go. And down the tunnels we go. Our next move is going to be northwest. Here we are. I'm just glad that the piano puzzle went so quickly, because that thing can be an ordeal unto itself. Why did it just accidentally hit forward at dead end? Northeast it is. Now we arrive here. Our next move shall be to the north. And now we will come on to our final move in this maze. And if I have inputted all the directions correctly, we should at last be free. Oh, we're getting some angle, on the track. Some sick stunts for real. Our final movement shall be to the southeast. East. Southeast. Now this should solve the puzzle. If it doesn't, we're screwed and I don't know what to do. Nah, we did it, gamers. We for real solved the maze by cheating. By cheating, of course. We did it. Now we can safely leave. Hold on, we gotta crack open the side of our sub here. And lo and behold, the final Mist Linking book. Now, we've been teleporting through a lot of books, so I feel it is germane that I explain what is happening. You see, Atreus, like I mentioned earlier, is from a group of people who have the ability to use writing to create these books called linking books. And these books allow them to transport themselves to places called ages. Those are all the places that we have been to on our journey throughout Myst so far. Those are all different ages. So Atreus has written these books. Once he writes the books, he can use them to go to these places. Does the art of writing a linking book create the world you go to, or does it merely open a gateway to a world that already existed? It's hard to tell. Hey, Cirrus.
You finally reached Herbert. I owe you a debt of gratitude, for you have nearly released me. My name is Cirrus. I trust that from your explorations you have become convinced that my wicked brother, Akatar, is guilty. I missed. It is I who am wrongly imprisoned here. Imprisoned by my father. I don't know who you are, or how you came to this island, but I assume you must at least know something of the books. It was father who was a master of the books. He wrote hundreds, all describing and linking to the fantastic places and ages which he had discovered.
Oh, I forgot that Cirrus is going to explain how linking books work.
Our father's library. It was here in this room, on this island named Myst, that he housed most of these books. But such a waste. By now, you have surely discovered that Akinar has burnt you to the end of most of these books. Why? Our father was always watchful of our explorations. We grew up under his strict supervision. But when we came of age, he gave us unbridled access to the Myst books. He began to leave our adventures more and more unchecked. Unsupervised as we were, my brother began to become disturbed. He began to take more from the Myst ages than he had given. Soon he gained a twisted pleasure. The conquest and destruction of the other ages. It was horrific. His thirst for destruction. But alas, even I discovered his insanity too late. He had completely destroyed all of the Myst ages but four. I wasted no time. In warning my father, I thought he would recognize Akinar's guilt. But in a fit of rage, he imprisoned both my brother and myself within the pages of these books, designed to hold us until he could judge which of us was guilty. To discover the truth, our father embarked on one final journey. However, he has never returned. I can only assume that he perished along the way, leaving me an innocent victim. But now, you are here to release me. Listen carefully. You must find one more page and I will be forever free.
One last page.
There is a book on the shelves.
On the shelves?
The library, which is mostly burned, but has a few pages still intact. It is the last book on the middle shelf.
Last book on the middle shelf?
This book is filled with a variety of patterns. Find pattern 158 and recreate it on the door of the fireplace.
Pattern 158.
Last red page.
Last red page.
Bring that page to me, and I will finally be released. And able to reward you, of course. Ignore the blue page. That page finishes my brother's book. It chills me to even think what would happen. There is another warning. Where the red and blue pages reside, also resides a green book.
A green book.
If you touch the green book, you also will be imprisoned forever.
If we touch the green book, we will be imprisoned forever.
This same warning long ago. I suggest you follow his advice. Go now.
Their father warned them never to touch the green book because it would trap them forever. Their father, Atreus, has trapped all of them inside these books until he can judge who is guilty. Now, we know that both of these nasty boys be guilty as fuck. So, we aren't going to help either of them. Ah, here we are. Pattern 151. Was it 151 that he said? Excuse me, which pattern did you bid me make?
You don't yet have the final page. You must not have understood my directions. Find pattern 158.
Ah, 158. My mistake. Just shut the book on him. 158. There are actually like hundreds of pages here. 4, 5, 4, 5, 5. Here we go. 158. Okay, I'm going to take a picture of this so I can replicate it accurately. Ah, yes. Number 158. And he said go to the fireplace. Inside the fireplace, if I... Oops. Go back to the fireplace, gamer. There you go, little one. If I push the little button, I will be brought into this place. I'm going to save the game. Green. Save. Resume. Now I need to make the pattern. Ow. Why is that so loud? Okay, and then... Oh, whoops. Okay, and then... And then one more right here. That looks correct. Right? Yeah, that looks correct to me. And then the fireplace... shall spin around and reveal the blue page, the red page, and the green book. Now, if I complete either brother's book, they will trap me in a book forever and leave me to die. Instead, I will touch the book they told me not to, and I will open it.
Who the devil are you? Don't come here to Dunny. Not yet. Oh, I have many questions for you, my friend. As you no doubt have for me. Should I begin? Oh. Perhaps my story is in order. My name is Atreus.
Atreus.
I fear you've met my sons, Cirrus and Achenar, in the red and blue books on Mist Island. In my library. My library. Oh. It contains my works, my writings. Oh, I wrote many books. Many books that linked me to fantastic places. It's an art I learned from my father many years ago. Oh, but the red and blue books, those were different. I wrote those books to entrap over-greedy explorers that might stumble upon my island of mist. But I had no idea my own sons would be entrapped. My son. Cirrus and Achenar, we had many journeys together. I gave them free rein to the books. Perhaps it was not wise. I could see the greed growing in them. I had not told them about the red and blue books. Their imaginations went wild. They dreamed of riches and power. They did not know the books were traps. They begged me for access to those books, and I, of course, denied them. Oh, they devised a plan, an evil plan. I had no idea to what extent their greed had progressed. Their own mother, they used their own mother. Dunny. Of course, I could return to Myst, except that they removed a single page from my Myst linking book. I cannot return without that page. You, my friend, can bring that page to me. Oh, I pray you believe my story above the lies that my sons have told you. If you could find it in yourself to return that page to me here in Dunny, I could go to Myst and bring justice to my sons for what they've done. I must return to my writing. I pray that you believe me. Please hurry. Bring the page. Bring the page with you.
So I can actually click on his image right now, and it will take me to Dunny. Dunny is where Atreus is trapped right now. If I do go to Dunny, though, I will die. Or I will be trapped there forever along with him, and that will also be a bad ending. Instead, I need to find the one page the brothers tore out of his Myst linking book. If he can take that page and return it to his book, then he will be able to come home to Myst. Now, you remember those two sheets of papers, the ones that were shredded in half? We found each half of that clue in a different age. If you take those two ripped pieces of paper and put them together, you will be able to read out that the clue will tell you that in order to get the last green page, the brothers locked it inside of one of the map markers. You have to turn all of them to the on position, and then you have to go to the dock and turn this one off. This will reveal the last green page that I need to restore the Myst linking book. This will allow me to free Atreus, and he will bring justice to the two sons who destroyed these ages, which also means we have to listen to this again. Shit. Messed it up. I'm not looking at my reference right now. I'm just doing it by hand, my gamer. It's really loud for you too, right? Because this is very loud. This game has no sound options lest I would change them. Fuck. What am I missing? Goes back to reference. Oh. Right. I was missing. That dot right there. Fuck. Messed it up again. I swear I'm not. This isn't a bit. I am actually messing this up. There we go. Okay. Sorry. Got too cocky. Too much cock. Hey, I'm coming, Atreus.
Have you found the missing page?
Yeah, I got it right here. Damn, my man really said come. For real. So now I am in Dunny. Can see that Dunny is falling apart. There are cave-ins everywhere. You can see all the doors here. So Dunny is falling apart, and because it's falling apart, Atreus is stuck here riding inside his book of Dunny. And he is keeping this world together by writing inside that book. We're not this world. He's keeping a world. Okay.
Ah, my friend.
Whatever. The book he's writing in is important. So that book he's writing in. Let me talk. Slow down. So the book he's writing in. Oh my god, shut. I'm walking away. So the book he's writing in is a book that contains a world. That world is very important, and the world is falling apart. In order to keep the world from fully falling apart, he has to keep writing inside the book, which is why he is stuck here writing. There's the page for you, bud.
You've done the right thing.
He's going to crack open his missed linking book and put back in that final page. Gonna reseal the page in there. Watch this. And it is sealed. Love that. Those special effects. So he's gonna do what we've been doing, and we get to see how moving through the books works.
I know what I must do. I shall return shortly.
Places your hand on the book, and he gets transported to the Isle of Mist. He's doing his good business. He's dealing with his sons. He knows what he has to do. And whenever he has finished dealing with them, he will come back.
It is done. I have many questions for you, my friend. But my writing cannot wait. I fear that my delay. They've already had a catastrophic impact on the world, in which my wife Catherine is now being held hostage. Now, in reward, I'm sorry, but all I have to offer you is the library on the Island of Mist, the books that are contained there. Feel free to explore at your leisure. I hope you find your explorations satisfying. You will no longer have my sons to deal with.
So, he has to keep writing in that book?
Oh. And one more favor. I am fighting a foe much greater than my sons could even imagine. At some point in the future, I may find it necessary to request your assistance. Until that point, feel free to enjoy the explorations from my library on Mist. Thank you again.
So his wife has been kidnapped and is being held hostage, and he must fight a foe far greater than his sons could ever imagine, and at such time...
The book. I'm... The Mist linking book to return.
Atreus, my friend, I know how to use the linking book. And whenever he needs our help, he will call upon us. And when he does call upon us, that is Mist 2. You'll see that he has destroyed his sons. They've been burned away. That is the end of Mist. We have gotten the best ending to the game of Mist, Masterpiece Edition. We saved Atreus. We destroyed his wicked sons. And when next we play a game on stream, we shall be playing Mist 2. That game is called Riven, the sequel to Mist. Now, whenever we start that game, Atreus is going to call us back to Dunny, where he is going to tell us about the captor of his wife and about the foe that he has to fight, and we're going to help him fight that foe, and that is the second game, Riven, the sequel to Mist. But we did it. We beat Mist. Puzzle game done. We did it, gamers. I hope you all found the game of Mist interesting. It's one of the puzzle games that's been with me for the longest time. I've never completed it until about a year ago. It was the first time I ever actually beat the game Mist. I played it when I was very, very, very young. We had a version of Mist on, I believe they have a version of it that you can get on mobile devices like an iPad or a phone. And I played Mist there many, many years ago, and I never really figured out any of the puzzles. And I played Mist again about a year ago. I just sort of stumbled into it on a whim. And I think it's a very fun puzzle game. It has a lot of weird lore. And now we know some weird lore, and we get to play Riven, the sequel to Myst, a game that I have never had the chance to play before, but I will have the chance to play now with you all for the first time ever. I've seen a playthrough of all the other Myst series games. There is, I believe, 4 of them in total, but I will not lie to you, I barely remember any of the puzzles as were solved in these walkthroughs, which means we're really going to have a headbutting time as we try to figure out how to do underground rocket ship mazes, no doubt, because I believe that there are still puzzles as difficult as that maze, but I don't believe they're ever as obtuse as they are in Myst 1. Alright, it's time to find somebody to raid. I want to wait for nobody to go live, but at the same time I am terribly hungry and I very badly wish to eat food. Does anyone have any suggestions of who to raid? Because I do not know anybody that is doing things. I don't see anybody to raid, gamers. Maybe we should just wait here for nobody to get back. Maybe we should start playing another game, gamer. What game shall we play? After this was done, I was going to play either Genshin Impact or FF14 so I could start knocking out my dailies. I was going to play Genshin. You guys want to play Genshin? Play a little goofy Genshin? Let's try that. Oh, hey, credits. You can see it's not a huge team that made Myst. It was a 90s adventure game, so. Banishing you back to the intro screen while I figure out how the heck I'm going to do this. Here's an excellent question, my gamers. I need to go into the mode where I don't accidentally switch the... You know what? Doesn't matter, does it? How do I go into the preview mode thingy on OBS? Oh no, I did not want to do that. That's annoying. I would Google it, but I suppose I can. Activating studio mode allowed you to change your scenes in the background without your viewers being able to see said changes. That, my friends, is most excellent. Okay, so I hit studio mode. Now we're in studio mode. Okay, there's that, and then I need to change the window capture. Okay. Then launch Genshin. Will this function correctly? This is the key thing I need to understand. Because I am using a service to let me play. I think this is working. This is working. Okay, epic. Well, let's make sure I don't have to actually enter my MoHoYo. Oh, you know what? Just realized my UID on Genshin is not going to be covered up. I need to fix that. I'm entering my password and stuff. Shut up. Stop talking. Let me do this. Ow. Oh, I dropped my phone on my keyboard. That was a mistake. Sorry. Type in my elaborate, long-ass fucking MoHoYo account password. It just be like that sometimes, you know? I like that it makes you do the security, you're not a robot thing, even if you enter your password incorrectly, like I just did. I appreciate that energy, MiHoYo. There we go. Now I have to do the puzzle thing again. I did it correctly, right? Surely, gamers. I'm gonna have to find some funny random JPEG on my computer to put over the UID. Cause I don't trust y'all to not be silly little goofers, you know? Image. I want an image source. I'm gonna call it image for real for real. You can hear the game, right? Surely. Oh fuck. Oh, that's bad. Hold on. I just realized that I logged off inside of a boss arena in Genshin. Forgot that you can just log off in the boss's actual arena. Kind of funny. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. There we go. Anyways, back to OBS. It's time to pick an image. No. Will that work? It works! That's really stupid. I'm so sorry for what you are all about to bear witness to. I beg your forgiveness in advance, and I hope that you will find it in your hearts and in your minds to forgive me for what I must do. Give me some nature sounds for Genshin. Okay. Okay. Hold on, I'm almost prepared. I'm very nearly ready. Okay, hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. It's almost done. I need to copy. Paste. There we go. I'm sorry, this is going to be the most intolerable Genshin Impact stream. And that's just how we're going to have to live our life, gamers. I don't know how to...
Created another universe and founded paradise.
It's just how it's going to have to be.
I, Fischl, and the princess in different...
It's just... Okay. Okay. Wait, hold on. Hold on. Poggers. Why am I not there? There I am. Okay. All is right in the multiverse. I did it. Look at me go. Are you proud of me, chat? I've added more GIFs to cover up the UID. God, this is so stupid looking. This looks so stupid. What a beautiful thing I've done. Good times.
I created enough.
I guess I'll fucking run dailies. Tell me if the game volume is too loud. Oh, right, I need to switch over to have chat on my phone so I can actually see if anyone says anything. Oh, I should probably change the information on Twitch so that people know what's going on. Dailies. Now I have to look up Genshin on Twitch. Genshin Impact, there we go. There, I did it, gamers. There it is, okay. Got leeway commissions today, I guess. Oh, is there, there's like an event or something going on right now. I was informed that it, Ooh. I still don't know how to do fishing in this game. It's like there's a character's birthday, and as part of the birthday event, there's rewards of some sort. I desire those rewards. You feel me? Mail. Hey, there we go! Nice. Is this actually enough for... another universe and found it. Nah, the beetles were enough for me to get all the materials I needed. Thank you, gift.
It appears my combat abilities are
become more powerful. Give the boy the sauce. Oh, whoops. I forgot that I can't sack multiple. 48. I need two more levels. Oh, hey, dude. There we go. 50. Nice. God, I really need to level up Yoimiya. He's still stuck at 40. I think my characters need to be around 60 for where I am in the game. Found in Tatarasuna. I assume that is also in Inazuma. Official and the princess. Oh, right, doing dailies. Almost went off on a whole other thing. Doing dailies right now. Gotta focus up, you feel me? Are those breadsticks? June, I don't know what you're talking about. What are you talking about? Breadsticks? You sound insane right now, June. You okay, bud? You feeling alright? It must be the new Genshin update? Maybe, but I don't know. I don't see any breadsticks, so, you know? Thing on this guy real fast. There we go. I love this. I just got this new Wind Boy, who do the punchy and the kicky, and he real fun. You're right. I must get tired from teaching. We love June here. This is a June friendly environment. How have you been, June? Did you only switch over to watch my stream because you saw that I had started playing Genshin? Well. It's unreachable. I guess I'll just never get that Geoculus, I suppose.
You don't want to do this.
Oh, right, I can make them drown. I sometimes forget that you can drown them. They must all drown. It is the only way. Oh, or they just die. That also works for me. I just finished my shift. I'm waiting for my car, because Rip Rip said 10 more minutes. So I'm waiting for another minute to wake her up, lol. Are you her alarm clock? Do you wake her up? Is that your duty? That's so funny. Yeah, I'm screaming in the phone now, lol. What a pleasant way to wake up, being screamed at. But we all know that Rip wouldn't want it any other way. Lord Vogodat. Okay. I don't even know what I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to check on the suspicious location. Okay. How far away is said suspicious location? That's far. That's far away. It's very far. I'm working on another character, Rosaria. I want to make her my main DPS, even though she's not a meta pick. We woke her up. I could finally go to the toilet now. June, oh my god. Go piss, June. Get out of here. Go piss. You gotta go pissy, buddy. It's not good to hold all your piss in. So I'm working on Rosaria. I know that she is not considered a meta pick for being a main DPS, but I like her, and I think she's cool, and I'm gonna build her to be a main DPS anyways. Rosaria can hit big numbers. I mean, I want her to hit big numbers. That's what I want. I want Rosaria to hit big numbers, but I need to farm all of like the thingies to make her big strong. I just unlocked the teapot yesterday, and I've done nothing inside of the little teapot world. I think I'm supposed to do stuff in the teapot. Damn, Godet blind. These ain't people. These do be the churls for real, though. So much damage. We love numbers. Now I report back. Wow. You know what? I always like the teleportation in Genshin. It's very snappy. I like that I can get places quickly. Yes. Okay. I keep glancing at the clock because I'm waiting for the promised time. Hey, wait. Chat, I have a very important question that I need you to answer. Nobody is streaming today, right? I did not double check the announcements page of her Discord to ensure that she was in fact streaming. There's a non-zero chance that she may not be streaming today, and I'm just biding my time for nothing. God, I'm gonna eat food. I'm hungry. I'd be hungry for real. Push. Hit push. Impeccable defense. Oh, ye old monolith challenge. We love to see it. You know what? I've never done one of these monolith challenges without it being part of one of my dailies. I assume you can just do these out in the world without having it being part of a daily. Ooh, should not have hit the explosive barrel. Ouchie. Oh. I just removed that hilly churl. He didn't even fall out of the tree. He just vanished. Oh my god. He's dead. Brutal. Yoimiya really said fireworks are for happiness, but also for brutal murder. Is that the last one that I have? I did 1, 2, 3, yeah. This is the last one. Then I need to beat up Iceman. Ice plant. We need to beat up the icy cold plant. Then once the icy cold plant has been beaten, I can hopefully get the drops I need to level up Rosario again. I'm at my PC. I think you mentioned Teapot before I left. Yeah. I just unlocked Teapot. My brother, who also plays Genshin, discovered that the Teapot is how you get the materials to level up artifacts. It's how you get more... Oh, I don't have any left. It's how you get the level up item for relics. Just like the weapons have like little crystal thingies that you put in them. You know what I mean. You know what I'm talking about. Teapot isn't really mandatory. You can pretty much play the whole game without doing it. But it does give you some quality of life stuff. That's precisely why I am interested in it. I'm interested in that quality of life stuff to make leveling things a little easier. You know? Also, I've been sitting on top of a world level quest for like a while, and I should really probably do it.
Bring it on.
Oh, I love the wind punch so much. Very big and strong and good.
On, reveal thyself.
Oh my god. It just killed them. They're dead. yeah, doing world level stuff would be pretty good, lol. Yeah, it's like playing Final Fantasy and then you don't do any of your job quests. Like, I don't do any quests in this game. But also, I've had this for like a long time. And I should really do it. Like a long time. First I have to go to Leeway and get my rewards. Also, I haven't picked up any of my adventure rank rewards. That was me if I was a person. Wait, that was me. That was me. I was that person. Oh, that doesn't do your job quests in 14. I don't know. Sometimes you're like going on a big leveling streak as you do your dailies on a job, and you're like, I don't want to stop and go and do the jobs right now. I'm leveling. But then, you know, you get around to it, just like I'm getting around to picking up... I did zero class quest stuff, then Gobel told me about it, and I was like, oh, well... Oh, the fact that it gives you, like, a bunch of all of your most important buttons for your job, like, all of them after 30. Oh, no! That's really how it be sometimes, though. I'm so sorry, bud. Yay. And then I have to do this one, and then everything will get very hard. Scary. But should I do it right now? Because if I do level up my world, I'm not going to be strong enough to fight the plant. I need to fight the plant first. If I don't fight the plant, I won't be strong enough. Yay, I'm silly. Crying. You're not that silly, June. It's okay. You'll always have Rip-Rip. And she will always call you silly. That was supposed to be comforting. It wasn't. It was just some cold, hard truth for you.
Leave it all to me. Time to clean up.
By the way, I'm using Barbara as a healer. I hope that's not too controversial. She's the most consistent. I have Barbara, but I refuse to use Barbara as a healer. I will use Noah instead. Is doing numbers for real. Oh, he swings whatever way I'm facing, I guess. We love iframes. We love gaming, we love iframes. We love dodging attacks. You know, just a little healing as a treat. Oh wow, that hit me. Oh, that combo keeps going. No, leave your head down so I can smack it. Bring it down here. Give me your face. Oh, it reformed just as I was breaking. Not what I wanted. Leave it up to me. That we can do it that way if you want, Betsy. Goldfish of Doom, very strong. Oh, almost got it. Can I just chip away at his stock and get him? That felt like a cheap kill. It feels wrong to kill him without doing it during his down phase. Give me two of the thing. Yes! Okay, now I feel okay. Leveling. I just wanted to ascend Rosario another rank. You know how it be. There we go. Now I need to level the world and do a bunch of XP farming, I guess. Oh, I also just found out that you can add more than one at a time by holding the plus button. That's a fun discovery. Yes. Big and strong. Big and strong. I should probably actually put her on my team, huh? I don't know who to replace. I don't know which of my team members I should replace, because I do like Wind Punch Boy. I like him a lot. I like all my characters right now, but I also like Rosario. If I had to replace one character, it would be Noelle, but Noelle is the only person who's doing any healing, you know? It's a real crossroads, my gamers. It do be a real crossroads. Enter the ruins. What am I doing here? Recommended party level 60? 40, 54, 50, 45. Okay. okay. Alright. This is gonna be really hard. Does this heal at all? It's just the place where you resurrect when you die. You got this. You overestimate how much I got this. I mean, Noelle doesn't do any damage, but she's just built to have a lot of defense because that's what gets her healing. Someone needs assistance. Can I just ring out these guys? Ow! Jesus! This is what I want. There we go. If you can't kill him normally, just, you know, this guy! What are you doing out there, bud? You were supposed to fall and die! There you go. Hey, if you can't beat him one-to-one, cheese him. You know? You feel me? Okay, I'm gonna official, and then I'm gonna use Swirl Boy after I heal. Okay. Official. Oh, this is not the correct button for me to push. Still works. Because Swirl Boy do this. Oh shit. I did not think that there would be a Ruin Sentinel here. Oh, problem. This is what we call in the industry an issue. Because I can handle probably one of these boys, but I don't think I can handle both of these boys. Cool. I'm glad we're doing this bin move right now. It's just really good. Hey, we love the iframes on our burst. Ow.
I'll catch up. Odd reveal that.
Big kick.
Bring it on.
Yes, number get bigger. Ow. Ow. Official on cooldown, Yomiya not on cooldown. Nope, target other one. No, target this one. Never mind. No, forget about it, Yomiya. I didn't want to pop that electro. There we go. Ow. Well, hey, got rid of the shield.
Fracture.
More healing time. Don't love rockets right now.
By royal, the field is lit.
There we go, one down. See, I can do this. It'll just take a little bit. Oh, shield. Don't love shield. Special, you have first. First this boy and put an element on him so I can swirl with it first. It is gone. Again, more bird. There we go. Got him. Oh, I have to do like the floaty thing now, huh? That's gonna be rough. Hey, yo, did anyone know if nobody went live? Is she here? Where is she? I need to check her Discord. I don't have chat up. I'm checking the Nobody Discord. I'm going to announcements. Stream maybe shortest tonight, 8 p.m. EST. She should be live. What's she doing? She being silly, being goofy, being wild? Very interesting, chat. I have to deal with these archers immediately. Or else this is gonna get very bad. I missed so bad. There we go. Just hit him a couple times. Not
that didn't count.
Okay, that was a little disrespectful. I feel a little disrespected by that one. It hurts a lot too. Okay. Come down here. I'm safe here. Not safe here. This is the most unsafe. This is dangerously unsafe. Just need to knock them off their platforms. Oh, great. Wizards coming through. That's great. Good for me. I love that for myself. I love fighting the wizards. Just fall. Just fall and die. Okay, fine. I do actually have to kill these guys for real, though, right? I'm gonna come up here. Where it's safe. I assume that the laser doesn't come all the way over here. Okay, that's one.
Gotta watch it.
Through platforms? Really? The bubble tracks and goes through platforms. That's good to know. Love that for me. Hello.
I must leave no stone unturned.
Can I heal, please? Let me heal off of you. Thank you. I would just like a little health back is all, you know. What? Did he die from falling? Did they die from falling? I didn't think that the wizards could die from falling. Okay. Oh my god, are you kidding me? You're still alive? This dude. This with this guy. Please die. The fireworks don't even reach him. There we go. No way. The wizard actually died from falling? That's nuts. I didn't know that they could do that. I've never managed to push one of them off before. Oh. Troublesome setup. I'll just not walk back there. Come here. There you go.
By royal decree, time for a light show.
Big numbers, big numbers, big numbers. Alright. Hello.
Leave it all to me.
I need a little healing. I should have healed on the big guy. Would have been less inconvenient than with the archers. Pop, pop, pop. Can I hit them with this? That works? It does work. Excellent. Just an unnecessary amount of force. Yep. No, stop climbing the box. Here we go. Oh, here we go. Here's the big scary room. Oh no. This is gonna be a rough one, huh? We'll deal with the little ones first. That's gonna be much easier. The solo Patui agent, I think I can handle. Bye-bye, Patui agent. You can hang out there by yourself until I'm ready to handle you. What part of by yourself until I handle you is not very clear. This guy, this freaking dude. So disrespectful, these Patui agents. Did so much damage to me.
I must leave no stone unturned.
That he's still electrified.
I'll catch up. Bring it on. By royal
decree. Oh, I wasn't paying attention. Yeah.
Prepare yourself.
Come here. Big smackies. Stop. God, when they get knocked in the air, it's very funny. Really? More ads? We love that. He popped my shield. Not what I wanted. It's not good. At least the big sword will send him flying, which is nice. No, rat. Oh, he just sent a reflection forward rather than actually attacking.
Leaving so soon.
It's like, hello?
Time for a light show.
There we go. Do a little juggling. I feel like I ran down the timer too far for comfort there. Not bad with characters who are 20 levels under. Whoops, forgot. I forgot, C's. Here, Rook. Is that laser gonna come back up out of the floor? Yeah, it is. I should have like trusted my gun on that one, eh? Oh, this is the water and ice thing. I hate this one. This one's rough. Nope! Oh, no. There we go. I'm glad I was able to avoid so much of the spam. Oh, this is gonna be deeply unpleasant. Okay. And lasers, that's nice. Okay. Cool. Very cool. No, not bubble. No! I hate the bubble move that the water ones do so much. It's so bad. It's so rough. It's so terrible. Okay. We do a little juggling. There we go.
Leave it at you.
Thank you. I should just watch them to do the bubble windup, shouldn't I? Because it has its own windup. Like that. Not the worst room we've done. That made the most annoying, though.
Midnight Phantasmagoria.
Fracture!
It seems like the lasers don't do much against him. Challenge. Defeat Electro Hypospaces in 480 seconds. Okay. He's not prepared for Electro Hypostasis. Wow, I'm really not prepared for level 40 Electro Hypostasis. The good old walk sideways.
Time for a light show.
How I forget that when he's firing projectiles, he's vulnerable. Really bad time. I don't remember what this does. Oh, it's outside. Okay, good. Then I assume that he will translate to an inside attack whenever this is done. Why did I do that? Yeah, it does. It does transition to an inside attack. Okay. We love predictability in our games. That was weird.
Fire hazard.
I can feel the timer running out on me. Oh, right, this.
Ooh.
It gets faster. I got it in the big one. 5 minutes. Oh god.
Leave it all to me.
Okay. Be fast enough. Come on. Yes. That was very scary. Oh, 37. I was a little bit behind on my adventure rank, it turns out. Guess I'll go pick up some tasty rewards and roll on the banner, I suppose. Is nobody live now? Where is she? I miss her very much. I wish to see her streams and go hee hee tee hee at them. As one does on such streams. She's playing Papers, Please! God. Flash raid. Lovely. Guys, we're going. We're going to say hi to nobody. Okay? Go to your elite gaming chairs, gamers. It's time to go hang out with nobody. I will see you all, I guess whenever I see you again, and we'll play Myst 2 and it'll be lots of fun. But until then, go say hi to nobody. She's very sweet and nice, and you should all like her. Okay, bye-bye.